Shut up.
Hey guys, this is my 36 gallon bowfront that I'm showing you. Right here is my bubble coral. It's one of the newer corals that I put in my tank. Then I am going up and showing you a leather coral that hasn't opened yet. And then right here is my frog spawn coral. We have a fan worm right here, and they're really cool. If you scare them, they go into their tube. Right here we have our porcelain crab and a favia. It's sitting on the favia. We're gonna pass by my frog spawn coral, and there's my flame angel fish and my yellow tang, which are probably about 4 years old each. There's a mushroom leather coral that isn't open right now, and I'm zooming in to see the urchin that's up there and my damselfish. Oh, and right there is my leopard puffer, my newest fish of the tank. He is blending in with his environment, and so far he's very happy in the fish tank. Their natural environment, leopard puffers like to live in caves, and they're actually a rarer fish to the aquarium hobby. I have a lot of caves in my aquarium, so figured the puffer would do very good in this environment. If you notice, I did a DIY background and I made a lot of caves. So right here I am showing you my rock flower anemone. I have three in the tank, and there's another leather anemone. Which isn't really opened. You can see is the polyps a little bit. Right here I have a damselfish. I have two of them in the tank. And also, right there is a hammer coral, and below is another hammer coral. You see up at the top, the green, it looks like green grass. That's the green star polyps, and they have covered my background through the years. Right there is another, that's a torch, and another porcelain crab. So, we go over here, and we have my Duncan coral, which has been around and growing multiple heads through the years. Right there you have my Blasto coral, and there's little Nemo, my clownfish. Over here, I'm showing you my new frags. You see some of my frags right there. And my green Kenya tree coral. There's my frag rack, and I'm showing you a couple leathers. I love my new weeping willow tree coral, which is now in my nano tank. I'm going to zoom in and show you, there's my yellow tang and my flame angelfish again. That's another, one of my newer corals, a brain coral. I have my gargonian right there and my villa garden. I love my villa garden, it's very colorful. I'm zooming in, there's my blue damsel, my blasto coral again. There's one of my hairy mushroom corals and my gargonian again. And my zoa garden, I'm showing you how colorful it is. There's my flame scallop, another rock flower anemone. The flame scallops are very cool. I have an electric flame scallop in my nano tank. Another damsel, which I only have two. They love the camera. And my pretty villa garden again. My 3D background has been actually flourishing over the years, and now it is alive. It's alive. And that was really neat to see it turn from completely non-living to now a living thing. What I'm trying to say it is now sustaining life, and it's become its own ecosystem, which is very, very cool to watch something you created become so alive and vibrant. I'm showing you a top view of my tank. I do have a sump running below, and I did everything myself. I just wanted to advise you, I did a lot of research before I even started this tank. It just took so much work, and now it is about 6 years old, and it is just the best hobby, I think. Thanks for watching, guys.